There's little question that one of the strangest rabbit holes in cosmology today is dark matter. Despite years of study, we still know next to nothing about this form of matter that apparently makes up about 85% of the matter in the universe. For galaxies to rotate as they do, dark matter seems to have to be present, though there are competing hypotheses that involve problems with our understanding of gravity itself, rather than any form of dark matter. The idea is simple on its face. For galaxies to behave as they do, they need more gravity than the sum of the visible materials within them can provide. Therefore, there must be other matter that we can't see, a lot of it, and for that to be the case, it would need to be in the form of some unknown kind of matter that cannot be detected through normal means. This could mean that dark matter is some kind of weakly interacting subatomic particle that's very abundant in the universe, but just doesn't interact with anything else except through the force of gravity. But since dark matter is linked with the behavior of galaxies, is it possible to have a galaxy made up entirely or nearly so of only dark matter? Such a thing would present a large amount of gravity but very few stars, and would be nearly or possibly completely invisible. Think a gravity source of great power that you have no way to detect other than its gravitational effects on other objects. But what might make them visible is if they contain a lot of hydrogen gas. Hydrogen has an interesting property with important implications. It emits radiation. Known as the 21 centimeter or hydrogen line, neutral hydrogen emits radiation at the frequency of 1420 megahertz. You've probably heard that number on this channel before. That frequency is SETI's main target frequency due to the notion that since hydrogen is the most common element in the universe, an alien civilization doing science would know of the 1420 megahertz hydrogen line. They would assume everyone else doing science in the galaxy would know as well, and use that as a natural basic broadcast frequency for contact signals. It's nature's way of providing a natural place for alien civilizations to discover each other and know where to tune the radio dial. And indeed, the infamous and still unexplained wow signal was at 1420 megahertz. And no, that signal was not due to comets, a common misconception these days. Despite the media attention on that hypothesis, the idea itself didn't get much traction in the scientific community since we'd see these kinds of emissions with other comets, and that hasn't been the case. Alien signals aside, regular natural neutral hydrogen does emit this radiation, so we can see it. So if large amounts of atomic hydrogen is spotted in space, but with no optically visible counterpart normal galaxy, then it's a candidate for a dark galaxy, or it's a gas cloud. But the biggest indicator would be the gravitational effects of the cloud on objects around it. If the behavior of those objects indicate a strong gravity source, then you might well have a dark galaxy. And there are candidates. The galaxy NGC 4254 is being pulled on by some powerful gravitational source, which appears to be a cloud of hydrogen gas called Virgo HI21 that shouldn't produce the gravity needed to do that on its own. But an underlying dark matter galaxy could. But what could these dark galaxies mean? One option is that they are newly forming galaxies, where the stars forming within them have yet to ignite. That would imply that the Milky Way might once have been a dark galaxy. Indeed, thinking on this is that large galaxies like the Milky Way formed through the merger of smaller galaxies, and possibly also dark galaxies. If dark matter galaxies are bringing lots of hydrogen with them, then that would provide the raw materials for the formation of large amounts of stars, leading to the large galaxy we have today. In addition to the concept of dark galaxies, there are more mysteries surrounding dark matter. I recently did an interview for Event Horizon, my long-form talk channel, link below, with Shani Danielli, a member of a team working with a Dragonfly telescope to study galaxies and dark matter. They've found some odd stuff indeed. In addition to finding a galaxy composed almost entirely of dark matter, well over 99% and a strong candidate for a dark galaxy, they've also found two galaxies that seem to have almost no dark matter at all. What does that imply? I asked her just that question, and the interview debuts this Thursday. Link to my Event Horizon channel in the description below. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently very concerned about dark matter. If this stuff is everywhere, gravitationally interacting with everything, then it's currently hovering around my desk. What effect does that have on my YouTube videos? Is it congregating around my coffee? Would coffee be better without dark matter? Is it the secret to good coffee? Very disconcerting, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.